Give It The Real Cause Off World podcast. We finna get into this Cash App situation. So the owner of Cash App, Bob Lee, has passed away yesterday. You know, someone stabbed him, I guess, multiple times, and he had to go to the hospital. Once he got to the hospital, I guess he succumbed to the injuries. But what I really want to get to about the situation is we need to start removing our money from the Cash App, period. We need to take our money off the Cash App, because if you're not hearing what's going on around the world, they are removing the U.S. dollar. So what that means is that it's not going to be that much value to it anymore in foreign countries. So with this Cash App situation, it seemed very on timing that this guy dies and then everybody want to switch their currency. If you don't know about Cash App, if you don't have it, let me run it down to you. It's pretty much an app. You can get direct deposit. You can, you know, get a savings account up there. You can get your Bitcoin, all types of stuff. But what I really want to talk about is the Bitcoin part too, because people with the that get the Bitcoin on Cash App, they don't know that if you save a certain amount of Bitcoin, one Bitcoin is at least worth like $25,000, $50,000. It depends on where the market is right now. And people will be able to invest in themselves with Bitcoin through Cash App. So what I see here is they really probably trying to get rid of him so they can do their own thing with his app. Because the Bitcoin has been selling off the fucking roof. I'm telling you, if you go to Cash App and you invest in Bitcoin, some days you might come back, and if you invest like $100, you might have $150, $200. If you invest $500, you know, it could turn into $1,000. So with this Cash App situation, Bob Lee, you know, I'm pretty sure he was a good dude. He didn't deserve this shit. You know, it's a lot of Illuminati type shit going on in the industry as of late. People being dying mysteriously, deaths like stabbings, getting killed, and then they set the car on fire, all types of shit, you know. And it really grinds my gears when the goddamn industry or the media try to act like they don't know what's going on behind closed doors when they really trying to take over these people's companies after death. It's so sad. And a lot of people got Cash App. People get direct deposit every day. And I remember this one time, guys. This one time, or maybe twice, I had some buddy on my motherfucking Cash App. So I go to the store to try to use it. And then it takes the money, but the store says my card declined. So I'm sitting here wondering what happened to my buddy on Cash App. 2 weeks later, they send it back, talk about, so we're sorry for the delay. Thanks. Come again next time. Whatever, you know, those banks be saying and shit. But it's all bullshit, bro. People be having a legit amount of money on Cash App, and then it disappears. And it's not me saying, oh, it's just conspiracy with the app, too. That's just the truth. A lot of people get money on Cash App. They try to send it or something like that, and it never goes through, or it'll send and it won't show up on the other person's account. Like, where does our money really go? Who's behind these, you know, computers processing these accounts and stuff like that? Think about that, man. So, you know, Bob Lee, man, I really don't think this guy deserved that, man. We're going to watch the video. Hit that like button, comment, subscribe. It's the Real Cause Off World podcast. Let's go ahead and get into the video.
We're learning new details about the stabbing death of a tech executive in San Francisco. Cryptocurrency startup MobileCoin confirms Bob Lee was killed early Tuesday morning. Lee was the founder of Cash App and the chief product officer of MobileCoin. San Francisco police say it happened on Main Street in the city's Rincon Hill neighborhood just after 2:30 in the morning Tuesday. When officers arrived, they found Lee with stab wounds. He was taken to a hospital where we're told he later died. This morning, MobileCoin CEO Joshua Goldbard sent this statement saying, quote, Bob was a force of nature. He helped to birth Android and Cash App into our world. Mobi was his dream, a privacy-protecting wallet for the 21st century. I will miss him every day. On Twitter, people are also remembering him using his Crazy Bob Twitter handle. Kyle Zink says, quote, was scheduled to work on MobileCoin with you tomorrow morning at Crazy Bob. You always believed in me. I'll be forever grateful. Now, no arrests have been made in this case, and San Francisco police have not yet released any details.